Hi everyone, I am Ehsan Karim from University of British Columbia. The title of my research project is The Performance of Statistical Learning Approaches to Construct Inverse Probability Weights in Marginal Structural Cox Models, a Simulation-Based Comparison. Here is the outline of the brief description of my research project. First, I will talk about some basic concepts. This study is motivated by the analysis of multiple sclerosis data from British Columbia. I will explain why I want to use statistical learning methods to estimate the inverse probability weights for the marginal structural Cox model. To assess the performance of these statistical learning approaches, I propose to use simulation studies as well as analyzing multiple sclerosis data. Now, let me discuss the basics first. A variable is a confounder if it affects both treatment and outcome. When we have too many confounders or too many levels of confounder, propensity score is a useful tool. To estimate propensity score, logistic regression models are popularly used. However, in the propensity score literature, it has been shown that the covariate balance sometimes improves if the propensity scores are estimated using the statistical learning techniques such as boosting, bagging, and support vector machine. Propensity score and inverse probability weights are functionally related. However, the nice feature of inverse probability weights is that these can be generalized to incorporate time-dependent covariates. Sometimes, such estimators are unstable and standard errors are unreliable. Therefore, various versions of weights are introduced to gain stability. As in the sample survey weights, these weights can be stabilized, normalized, and truncated based on specified percentiles. So far, we have discussed point treatment setting where we control the list of confounders L. This can be easily done by using propensity scores no matter how many confounders we have. However, in longitudinal studies, sometimes confounders are also affected by the previous treatment. Such variables act as confounders and intermediate variables at the same time. In epidemiology, they are commonly referred as time-dependent confounders. Let us see how the presence of time-dependent confounders affect our analysis strategy. If we fit a Cox proportional hazards model with the baseline confounder L sub 0 and time-dependent confounder L sub t, the analysis result will be biased since L sub t is an intermediate variable and we shouldn't control for it. If we fit the Cox model with just the baseline confounder L sub 0, the analysis is still biased because L sub t is also a confounder and we need to control for confounders. In marginal structural Cox model, the inverse probability weights are calculated first. As with sample survey weighting, these weights redistribute the population by creating a pseudo-population so that the biasing effect of time-dependent confounding variables is removed, and the association between outcome and treatment becomes unconfounded. In the pseudo-population, simply adjusting for baseline confounders will produce causal estimate of the treatment effect. From the literature, we know that the marginal structural Cox model estimates are highly sensitive to the weight model misspecification. Therefore, for the correct estimation of the causal parameter, the weights need to be estimated as accurately as possible. These models are popularly fitted using logistic regression models. As these weight models are generalizations of propensity scores, many researchers hypothesize that the statistical learning methods may be useful in estimating the weights, as was the case in propensity scores. Therefore, the objective of this study is to assess the performance of inverse probability weights estimated via different statistical learning approaches. As a secondary objective, we'll also compare various versions of weights and corresponding truncations at various percentiles. To assess these, I will use Young's algorithm to generate datasets suitable for fitting marginal structural Cox model. This study is motivated by the investigation of the impact of beta interferon treatment in delaying disability progression in subjects with multiple sclerosis. The findings from the simulation studies will guide the application of marginal structural Cox model in the real dataset. The dataset that we will analyze is collected from the British Columbia Multiple Sclerosis Clinic from 1995 to 2008. A few baseline confounders are present and relapse is considered as a time-dependent confounder. I will use marginal structural Cox model to deal with this time-dependent confounder. Here are some of the useful references. Thank you for taking time to watch the brief description of my research problem.